Welcome to another episode of Frame 316 Media, where I upload videos weekly that can help you grow your business using videos. If you are new here, please subscribe and hit the notification bell to not miss out on videos like this in the future. Today, I want to talk about why you should spend quality time working on your YouTube channel later. For those who are new to YouTube, your channel page serves as your homepage. There are three things that you should know about your channel page. First, your subscribers and new visitors will know what your channel is all about when they visit your channel page. Who are you and what are you up to? These are the two questions that your channel page answers for your visitors and subscribers. If you don't spend time working on a great layout, you will miss the opportunity to increase your subscribers. Second, you can customize the layout to create a strong impression on your channel. Make sure to choose the best videos and playlists that represent your channel. Viewers love consistency and relevance. Make sure you have the recent uploads prominently displayed so that your viewers will know that you're always uploading new videos. Third, the channel page content needs to be optimized so that you can get more views. Spend some time thinking about the relevant keywords that should appear on your playlist title, your basic info, and the featured videos for returning subscribers and non-subscribers. So how do you customize your channel layout to get more views and subscribers? First, optimize the sections. Make sure you add sections on your channel page with relevant keywords on the title and on the section description, which, by the way, should be your playlist. If you are not doing playlists yet on your YouTube, you should do it immediately right after watching this episode. You can do this by going to the YouTube studio and at the left part of your screen, click customization. This is a recent update to the YouTube studio. The older version does not have this option yet on the left navigation. The customization page has three main sections: layout, branding, and basic info. My second tip is for the layout section. Here, we have video spotlight and featured section. The video spotlight is the tip of the iceberg. This is what viewers can see on your channel. So make sure you choose carefully what videos you want to showcase here. And these videos should represent your channel. You can either create a short intro video or choose the best video that will let people know what to expect on your channel. You can add up to 10 sections here and make sure you choose single playlist when adding a section. You can also change the order of appearance if you want to. You can use the three dots on the right side of the panel to edit the section. This is important because it helps people find what you are offering immediately. So spend time writing your playlist title and description. A side note on playlists. As content creators, you should be thinking in terms of playlists and not single videos, so that in the long run, you would have a series of videos that help your audience and in return, grow your subscribers. Make sure you add the description for your playlist and that these descriptions are SEO optimized. The second section of your customization panel is branding. Here you can change your profile picture, banner image, and video watermark. The watermark is an amazing addition to the YouTube customization because it allows you to create that subscribe CTA or your channel logo. And you can choose the display time to end a video, custom an entire video. I highly recommend you choose to set it to show for the entire video. For your profile picture, although you will be uploading a square photo, it will be shown as a round image. So take note of that and do some tweaking in Photoshop or Canva just to be sure your profile picture looks good on your channel. Next tip, channel art design. This is very important. Make sure that people would know what you are offering by looking at your channel art. People would probably find you on the search page through a keyword tag that you use, and then once they are on the channel page, you do not want them to be confused. Depending on what your channel is all about, always try to keep it simple. For me, I'm teaching business owners how to use videos for their marketing strategy, hence my channel art design. A good practice is to update your channel art at least once every 3 months just to give your channel page that fresh look. the last section of the customization page is the basic info. Take note, the first 70 to 150 characters show up when you share your channel URL to Facebook and Twitter. So make sure to use that to explain clearly what your channel is all about. It has to make sense and be persuasive enough for viewers to subscribe to you. In this section, you can also add links to your website and other social channels. Just add the title and the URL. These URLs will show up on your banner image. Take note that only the first link will have a text shown on the banner image. Lastly, on your contact info, make sure you will not use the same email address that you use to log in on your YouTube channel, as this can serve as a backdoor for hackers to hack your channel. Remember that on your YouTube channel, content and context is important. You might have great content right now, but visitors may find it hard to understand what you are trying to offer them. So I hope you spend time following the tips I shared here and see your subscribers grow. If you have all these in place, make sure to watch the video that you see on the top right of your screen right now on how to edit your videos from start to finish. Again, if you see any value out of this video, please hit subscribe and the notification bell. My name is Robert. It's time to go to work. It's your time to grow. Thank you for watching and see you in my next videos.